Hi everyone! In this video, I'll be showing you the basics of using the CV, gate, and clock outputs on the Akai MPK Mini Plus. First, let's quickly cover what exactly CV outputs are and how they can be used. Simply put, the CV, or control voltage outputs, are an analog method of controlling oscillators, envelopes, and other parameters of external synthesizers, drum machines, and sequencers via standard 1/8 inch or 3.5 mm TS cables. This is a very useful way to link your MPK Mini Plus with analog and modular units in your setup to be able to modify settings on the fly. The CV outputs on the MPK Mini Plus are located on the rear of the unit, just to the right of the sustain pedal jack. You'll find three CV gate outputs. Pitch will send pitch messages to your external unit. Gate will send gate or note length messages. And mod will send modulation or velocity messages. Just to the right, you also have a CV clock input and output, which you can use to send or receive arpeggiator and sequencer clock data. To access the MPK Mini Plus's CV settings, press and hold the Shift button and tap Bank AB. Source controls whether your external unit will receive CV messages from your keyboard, a key sequence, MIDI channels 1 through 16, the pads, or the drum sequencer. Note order determines which played note will be sent via CV when multiple notes are being held down, the lowest, highest, or last note. Gate chooses which gate mode to use. In normal mode, the gate will be re-triggered with each pressed note. And in legato mode, the gate will continue in time through each newly pressed note. Mod source controls the mod CV output source, either the velocity of your keys or the mod wheel. Bend controls how many semitones you'll be able to bend the pitch of the note with the pitch wheel. Clock input division sets the number of trigger pulses that will occur before the sequencer moves to the next step. And clock output division sets the time output division, which will be sent by the clock output. Let's cover how to use the pitch output first. Plug one end of your TS cable into the pitch output on the MPK Mini Plus, and plug the other end into the corresponding input on the unit you want to control. In this case, I'm plugging it into the oscillator CV input on my synth. Now, since the source parameter in the CV settings is set to keyboard, playing notes on the keyboard will control the pitch of the oscillators on the other unit. And the bend setting lets me bend the pitch of the oscillators anywhere between 1 and 12 semitones. Next, let's check out the gate output. Connect a TS cable between the gate output and the appropriate CV input on your external unit. Here, I'm connecting it to the gate clock input. Now, pressing keys on the keyboard will control the length of each note played through the synth. Now onto the mod output. Connect your TS cable to the mod output and patch it into the relevant CV input on the secondary unit, which for this one is the mod wheel CV input. So on my external synth, I have a number of parameters I can set to be controlled by the mod wheel input, including the filter envelope, oscillator frequency and pulse width, and LFO root, which lets me manipulate my sound in a plethora of ways. Set your external unit settings however you wish to be able to change your sound simply by adjusting the mod wheel on the MPK Mini Plus. Finally, let's check out the clock input and output. You can use the clock output to send tempo information to your external unit. Plug a TS cable into the clock output and the other end into the gate or clock input on your other unit. Now, when you use the sequencer, arpeggiator, or note repeat functions, the BPM you select on the MPK Mini Plus will control the tempo of anything played through your secondary unit. Thank you. Conversely, if you want your secondary unit to control the MPK Mini Plus's tempo, plug one end of the TS cable into its clock input, and the other end into the gate or clock output on the second unit. Then press and hold the shift button and turn knob K6, and change the BPM setting to trig. Now, instead of using its own internal clock, your MPK Mini Plus will use any clock data sent via CV. So those are just some of the ways you can use the CV gate and clock outputs on your MPK Mini Plus in your setup. Be sure to check out the other videos in our MPK Mini Plus series. The link is down in the description. If you need further assistance with using your MPK Mini Plus, head over to akaipro.com/support, where you'll find AkaiPro's knowledge base and technical support portal. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll catch you next time.